Hello, my name is Roman Maslennikov. I am the director of Prostor PR and Consulting, a Russian PR agency. It is located in Moscow and it's one of the top 50 communications companies in Russia. PR became my profession more than 10 years ago, and I dedicated the recent 3 years to crazy PR or explosive PR. Let me tell you about crazy or explosive PR in Russia. By the way, I wonder what you call it in English. I heard spin, scandal. Is it correct? When I say crazy or explosive PR, I mean bombive, explosive newsworthy occurrences for the benefit of brands or persons. The occurrences that will appear in all the Moscow or national news broadcasts, naturally for free, with approximately 30-50 news created in 1-2 hours, 5 or 10 videos news can be filmed in a week, and so on. Now let me give you more details. Crazy PR in Russia looks pretty much like real news. It is practically impossible to distinguish between them. Yet, who knows, even being a professional, I may wrongly believe that something was true, although it was staged. Anyway, look at the aggregators of fun news and you will see crazy PR in Russia through life. For example, visit sites as breakingmad.me or hobosty.ru and so on. Some fake accounts are perceived as a genuine news sources. Peskov's mustache. Peskov is the press secretary of President Putin. By the way, he shaved off his mustache. Then Kremlin Russia, Fog News, Life.ru, etc. Another Russian peculiarity is scare specialists. Crazy PR professionals are literally like rocks in the desert. There are Oleg Matveyev, Stichy's book Earth Flatter the God, Wag the Dog, you know, and Wag the God. Anton Vuima, Stichy's books Lobbying or How to Make Authorities Take Decision You Need, and Black PR. And me, Roman Maslennikov, see my books, Anatomy of Information Explosive, Manifests of Communicative Leadership. Then, you know, you can see other specialists in explosive PR. Mikhail Chernyshov, Yuni Davidov, Oleg Voronin. They used to practice crazy PR in earlier times. That's it. I don't know anymore. Who does? Are they hiding themselves? For example, like Rospis Dot Projects. Rospis Dot Project. They had installed ever some social billboards causing powerful information resonance and disappeared. The third peculiarity, political consultants who used to create a lot of scandalous, newsworthy events in crazy PR format no longer do it. Why? Business PR for political consultants is the way from the Harvard to a full trade school. Now many of them are true power brokers of the global economic and informational process, or government officials. And finally, one more reason for the Russian crazy PR to remain scant. It's deficiently in teaching aids referring to our conditions. The USA and the UK, where crazy PR is more developed, in my opinion, have got such films, Tail, Walking the Dog, Absolute Power, Scandal, and others. It's nice that these films reached Russian professionals as well. But we have more examples of crazy PR in our literature. For example, Viktor Pelevin and his Generation P fiction book. You also had a super writer, former PR specialist Christopher Buckley. With all my respect, Viktor Pelevin is more powerful, I think. Classical PR professionals now tend to discuss whether crazy PR is ethical. I see such discussions to be meaningless, as crazy PR achieves its business goals: fame, awareness, profitability, and all of that promptly, without killing anyone. A few canonic cases of crazy PR: traffic accidents, exotic animals in the office, love story, bombarding with tomatoes. All these cases I have in my portfolio. Cases you can see at www.prostorvip.ru. Sorry, the site in Russian, but you see Google Translator and it was simple to read. I invite everyone interested in crazy PR to work together. Maybe we can make an international crazy PR project. It's fun, fantastic, and after all, let's make our life more joyful. For someone, business benefits, certainly. Let's start with connecting to each other, for example, on my Facebook account named exactly after the subject: scandal PR, sex in PR, and explosive PR. Sex, PR, and rock and roll. I think you find me, I find you, crazy PR specialists must be together. Let's talk. Sorry for my English. I communicate like a Minister Mutko, Minister of Sports in Russia. I promise I will be more communicatable in English, and the language of the explosive PR is universal, I think. Bye-bye, see you later in my Skype, in my Facebook, and in my WhatsApp. Bye-bye.